This is just going to be a quick video. I'm going to show you a different way to use your maker's marks or stamps that you've had made, if you've had had these ones made up, as you can see in the other video that I did, where you know you can get your own stamp designed. The usual way you're going to use these is obviously to case your leather, dampen it down, and then apply pressure the same as you would when you know put a normal 3D stamp on, or a tooling stamp or anything like that, and then you make the impression in the leather while it's damp. What we're going to look at with these is we're going to look at hot stamping or branding, whatever you want to call it. It's not really branding, I suppose. That's kind of when the sizzle cow's ass is in it, but you know, it's more hot stamping, I suppose. But what we're basically going to do is we're going to heat the stamp up, and then we're going to apply it to leather that's not cased. It's actually going to be finished leather, and we're going to manage to get the same result as we would from stamping normally. Now, there's a couple of different reasons that you might want to do this. As I say, if you're sort of doing your stamping normally, you need to do it at the start of your project, so before you've done really your dyeing and everything like that, because you've got to dampen your leather down. So one reason might be that you've kind of forgotten to apply your mark or something if you want to do it later on. Another reason might be that it's a bit more, it doesn't affect your dye as much, really. So, you know, if you case a piece of leather, put the stamp on and do all your tooling and so on, and then dye it. If you're dyeing a dark colour, you won't notice it so much. If you're dyeing something lighter like tan, you're going to find that because you've been sort of stamping and casing and stuff, the dye doesn't maybe go on as evenly. So sometimes it's easier to just dye the whole piece and do what you're doing, and then use this hot stamping method later, in terms of it not affecting the dye as much. Also, if you're working with sort of pre-dyed leathers, obviously you can do this. Anything that's already got a finish on it, you're going to struggle to case. So, you know, if you buy some finished leather, which you might do, then this is the method to use. This is what's used on kind of commercial things as well. So if you look, for example, at this iPad case, you can see the maker's mark there, or the company name, Kavaj, is stamped into this leather. Now, when they make things like this commercially, they don't sit there messing about casing the leather and, you know, applying stamps. They just have a hot stamping machine and it basically melts the stamp straight in. Those commercial machines are quite expensive. They're kind of a big thing that heats up and it plugs into the electric and so on, and then you know it gets it up to temperature and you basically pull a lever and it stamps it in. We don't have those machines and we don't really have the need for those machines, so we'll just look at a quick way of doing this. So what I've got here is just a heat gun. It's a 2 kilowatt heat gun, and this is what I've been using to do the kydex with, although I actually bought an oven now, so it's kind of retired from that duty. But this is what we're going to use to basically heat up the stamp. Now, these stamps are made of magnesium, and if you get magnesium too hot, it basically kind of explodes. If you think back to your chemistry at school, it's very volatile. The temperature that we're going to get this up to isn't anything like the melting point of the magnesium, so you don't need to worry that it's going to kind of blow up or anything like that. So all we're going to do basically is turn the heat gun on and apply heat to this. Now, the temperature that you need to get it to, without being too technical about it, it doesn't want to be cool enough that you can keep your fingers on it. If you can keep your fingers on it like that, it's not really warm enough. The best way that I can think to describe it is, if you ever put your hand on like a really hot radiator and you can't keep your hand on that radiator and you think, oh, that's a bit warm, you know, it's not going to melt the skin off your hand, but it's too warm that you really want to keep your fingers on, if that makes sense. So what you need to do is just keep the heat on, keep checking it just with your fingers, and then when it gets to that temperature where you think, oh yeah, that's a bit too warm to keep your fingers on, that's about ready then. So simply going to just apply heat straight onto it like this. Okay, that's only how long that's taken. Now, to be a bit more scientific about it, we can also take the temperature. That's reading about 65°C, okay? A hot radiator, generally you want those about 50°C, so again, that's quite a good analogy, but the melting point of this is really quite high. Right, Siri says it melts at 650°C. So if we're getting that up to, you know, 65-70°C and it melts at 650, you're nowhere near actually melting your stamp, so you really don't need to worry about that. So when I actually get the stamp hot, I've got my arbor press ready, and I'm going to position the stamp under the ram and use that to actually press down on the stamp. You know, you could do this with a clamp, but it'd be a bit more fiddly because obviously the heat starts to come out of this. You need to do it while it's quite hot. So you could use a clamp, but really, if you, for the price of these, they're worth the weight in gold. So I would recommend that you use something like this if you can. The most crucial thing is that you need to make sure you get it the right way up, obviously, because it's, you know, when it's hot and you're messing about and you're trying to get it in there, if you stamp it the wrong way up, you're going to have really ruined the piece of leather that you're working on. So once you've heated it up, just make sure you're aware of which bit's the top of the stamp, where it's going, and get it in there. So we'll actually get this stamped up now. I'm going to apply the pressure onto the stamp with it hot for maybe 4 or 5 seconds, something like that. That should be all it really needs. And it's just basically doing the job of melting the leather, or sort of, you know, compressing the leather down with the heat there. Then we can just carefully take that away. So there you can see the stamp that we've just made. That's an example from another thing that I've sort of half finished, but that was done in the same way, just to demonstrate for you. As you can see, it gives a nice crisp impression, the same as you would get from you know, successful stamp into some cased leather. So there's no real disadvantage to it particularly. And as I say, you can see how it sort of on that lighter dye there, because it's been done after the dyeing, it doesn't really affect the dyeing too much either. You can kind of get the dye just how you like it, apply all your finishes, so you're not getting kind of any finish stuck in any intricate bits of the pattern or anything like that, and then just apply that straight on top. It gives you some good results. So you know, it's fairly inexpensive to do. The heat guns aren't expensive, the arbor presses aren't expensive, and you might have that already. So you know, you can give it a go if you like. As I say, the magnesium, if you were to get it really hot, is dangerous. So don't try and heat it by putting it over a naked flame or a fire or anything like that. You're just applying heat with the heat gun, which isn't anything like as hot as a flame. Okay, and as I say, as soon as you get to that temperature where you're thinking a bit too hot to keep your fingers on, then that's plenty warm enough.